Welcome to the place where there is no darkness, for there comes a time when we must bring our own light to the world, and now is that time.
Lord, my home's in the Delta, way down that old sunny road. Lord, my home's in the Delta, way down that old sunny road. Lord, I ain't getting nothing in Chicago, oh Lord, but just my room and board. How could one people, how could people all be so mean? How could people, Lord, be so mean? Lord, I didn't have a nickel or a dime. My landlady done put me, Lord, out in the cold. All right, all right. I'm gonna catch the first thing smoking. Lord, back down the road I go. I'm gonna catch the first thing smoking. Lord, back down that old road I go. Lord, I ain't getting nothing in Chicago, hey, hey. Oh, Lord, but just my room and board.
Before I begin, I would suggest reviewing the definition of the word corona and all of its symbolic significance. Now, reading from Mackey's Encyclopedia of Freemasonry. Delta, a triangle, the name of a piece of furniture in a commandery of Knights Templar, which being of a triangular form derives its name from the Greek letter delta. It is also the title given in the French and Scottish rites to the luminous triangle which encloses the ineffable name. See Triangle. Turning to Volume 2. Triangle. There is no symbol more important in its significance, more various in its application, or more generally diffused throughout the whole system of Freemasonry than the triangle. An examination of it, therefore, cannot fail to be interesting to the Masonic student. The equilateral triangle appears to have been adopted by nearly all the nations of antiquity as a symbol of the deity, in some of his forms or emanations, and hence, probably, the prevailing influence of this symbol was carried into the Jewish system, where the yod within the triangle was made to represent the tetragrammaton, or sacred name of God. The equilateral triangle, says Brother D.W. Nash, quote, viewed in the light of the doctrines of those who gave it currency as a divine symbol, represents the great first cause, the creator and container of all things, as one and indivisible, manifesting himself in an infinity of forms and attributes in this visible universe. End quote. Among the Egyptians, the darkness through which the candidate for initiation was made to pass was symbolized by the trowel, an important Masonic implement, which in their system of hieroglyphics has the form of a triangle. The equilateral triangle they considered as the most perfect of figures and a representative of the great principle of animated existence, each of its sides referring to one of the three departments of creation, the animal, vegetable, and mineral. The equilateral triangle is to be found scattered throughout the Masonic system. It forms in the royal arch the figure within which the jewels of the officers are suspended. It is in the ineffable degrees the sacred delta, everywhere presenting itself as the symbol of the grand architect of the universe. In ancient craft masonry, it is constantly exhibited as the element of important ceremonies. The seats of the principal officers are arranged in a triangular form. The three lesser lights have the same situation, and the square encompasses form by their union on the greater light two triangles meeting at their bases. In short, the equilateral triangle may be considered as one of the most constant forms of Masonic symbolism. The right-angled triangle is another form of this figure, which is deserving of attention. Among the Egyptians, it was the symbol of the universal nature, the base representing Osiris, or the male principle, the perpendicular Isis, or the female principle, and the hypotenuse Horus, their son, or the product of the male and female principle. This symbol was received by Pythagoras from the Egyptians during his long sojourn in that country, and with it he also learned the peculiar property it possessed, namely that the sum of the squares of the two shorter sides is equal to the square of the longest side, symbolically expressed by the formula that the product of Osiris and Isis is Horus. This figure has been adopted in the third degree of Freemasonry and will be there recognized as the 47th problem of Euclid. Triangle and square. As the delta was the initial letter of the deity with the ancients, so its synonym is among modern nations. It is a type of the eternal, the all-powerful, the self-existent. The material world is typified by the square as passive matter, in opposition to force, symbolized by the triangle. The square is also an emblem of humanity, as the delta or triangle typifies deity. The delta, triangle, and compasses are essentially the same. The raising one point and then another signifies that the divine or higher portion of our nature should increase in power and control the baser tendencies. This is the real, the practical, quote, journey toward the east, unquote. The interlacing triangles, or deltas, symbolize the union of the two principles or forces, the active and passive, male and female, pervading the universe. The two triangles, one white and the other black, interlacing, typify the mingling of two apparent powers in nature, darkness and light, error and truth, ignorance and wisdom, evil and good, throughout human life. The triangle and square together form the pyramid, as seen in the entered apprentice's apron. This combination, the pyramid, is the metaphor for unity of matter and force. as well as the oneness of man and God. The numbers 3, 5, 7, 9 have their places in the parts and points of the square and triangle, when in pyramidal form, and imply perfection. Triangle, radiated, or radiated triangle. A triangle placed within and surrounded by a circle of rays. This circle is called in Christian art a glory. When this glory is distinct from the triangle and surrounds it in the form of a circle, then it is an emblem of God's eternal glory. This is the usual form in religious uses. But when, as is most usual in the Masonic symbol, the rays emanate from the center of the triangle and, as it were, enshroud it in their brilliancy, it is symbolic of the divine light. The perverted ideas of the pagans, in other words, the ideas of the pagans that were perverted, referred these rays of light to their sun god and their Sabian worship. But the true Masonic idea of this glory is that it symbolizes that eternal light of wisdom which surrounds the supreme architect as a sea of glory, and from him as a common center emanates to the universe of his creation.
Woman out the country, now I find you longing in your soft infertile too. And I wish the stars to satisfy your longing for the warmth and tender shelter of my body. Oh, you're mine, yes, you're mine. Concrete mountains in the sand.